Next question. If A and B are minus 2, minus 2, 2, 4 respectively, find the coordinates of P such that AP is equal to 3 by 7 of AB and P lies on the line segment AB. So we can draw a line segment AB. A is given as minus 2, minus 2. B is given as 2, minus 4. Okay, and it is given that P lies on the line segment AB. So, I am taking P which lies on the line segment AB. And the question is to find the coordinates of P. Since we need to find the coordinates of P, we can take the coordinate as XY. So, it looks like somewhat as similar to our section formula, isn't it? What all we require? X1, Y1 is given. X2, Y2 is given. And we have to find XY. Again, we require the ratio M is to N. The ratio is not directly given, but instead this equation is given. What's the condition given? AP is equal to 3 by 7 of AB. Okay, then can you say what will be AP by AB? AP by AB will be 3 by 7. Okay, so the full length I am taking as 7x. X can be any value. Okay, so the full length of AB I am taking as 7x. Then can you say what will be the measurement of AP? I am taking AB as 7x, then the measurement of AP will be 3x. Okay, that is why it is given as 3 by 7. The ratio of AP by AB is given as 3x, so that if I am taking AB as 7x, AP will be equal to 3x. AP is this much and AB is the full line segment. Then can you say what will be PB? PB will be equal to AB minus AP. PB will be equal to AB minus AP. That is 7x minus 3x, which gives you 4x. Okay. For example, suppose that you are taking AB as 7 cm. Then what will be the length of AP? AP will be 3 cm. Why? You know the ratio of AP by AB is given as 3 by 7. So then only you will get the value as 3 by 7. Then what will be the length of BP? BP from the figure, it is equal to AB minus AP. So that AB we took as 7 and AP we got as 3. So 7 minus 3 gives you 4. So here instead of taking 7 cm, we took AB as 7x. Because x can take any value, 7 into 2 or 7 into 3, whatever it is. Then AP becomes 3x. Then the ratio becomes 3 by 7. So that PB you are getting as 4x. Then the ratio which we require is AP is to PB, isn't it? So find the ratio AP is to PB. AP is to PB will be AP. What was we got as 3x is to PB we got as 4x. Then what will be the ratio? 3 is to 4. So here M is to N will be equal to 3 is to 4. So we have M is to N, we have X1, Y1, we have X2, Y2 and we have to find XY. Just apply section formula. How we can write XY? XY is equal to, write the formula M into X2 plus N into X1 by M plus N, that will be the X coordinate, and MY2 plus NY1 by M plus N, that will be the Y coordinate. So that is equal to M is 3, 3 into 2 plus N is 4 into minus 2 divided by 3 plus 4, which is M plus N, comma M is again 3, Y2 is minus 4 plus N is 4 into Y1 is minus 2 by 3 plus 4, which is M plus N. That's equal to 3 into 2, 6 minus 8 by 7, comma minus 12 minus 8 by 7. So this is equal to minus 2 by 7 comma minus 20 by 7. So thus we got XY is equal to minus 2 by 7 comma minus 20 by 7. What was XY? XY was the coordinate of the point P. And the question was to find the coordinate of the point P. Therefore, the coordinates of P is equal to X comma Y, which is equal to minus 2 by 7 comma minus 20 by 7. So the only extra thing in the question is instead of the ratio, the relation was given AP is equal to 3 by 7 AB. From there, we took AP by AB as 3 by 7. So since we got the ratio like this, we are taking AB as 7x. When AB equal to 7x, AP becomes equal to 3x. Okay, again AP is this much part and AB is the complete line segment. So to find the PB, what we will do is complete line segment, length of complete line segment 7x minus AP. That is how we are getting 4x. Then if we want to take the ratio AP is to PB, that is M is to N, AP we got as 3x and PB we got as 4x. So 3x is to 4x becomes 3 is to 4 and we are getting the value of M is to N as 3 by 4 and just directly applied the section formula. Mx2 plus Nx1 by M plus N and M by 2 plus N y1 by M plus N.